When most people think of the art world, they see this or this, and they usually ridicule it and say this is not art. These conceptual creations were made to challenge and deconstruct society's expectations of what art is in line with emerging postmodern thought. But what if you wanted to look at art to see the innate creative urge that has existed alongside humanity's development from the earliest years to the present day? Then you need to move your gaze from this over-conceptualized sector. Instead, begin to appreciate the work of other artists, such as the outsider artists, who tend to create intense and bizarre visionary compositions. So, what is outsider art? The term outsider art was coined in 1972 by the art critic Roger Cardinal. He defined it as an internationally recognized category of self-taught art which rests on the notion that art making is a widespread human activity reaching far beyond the world of public galleries, teaching institutions and culturally marked art production. He wrote, "It refers confidently to an actual fund of original work produced by untutored creators of talent whose expressions convey a strong sense of individuality." Cardinal declared that the term was intended to reflect Jean Dubuffet's L'Art Brut exclusively, but has since led a life of its own and has been abused and used in a variety of ways which have often compromised its usefulness as a technical term. So I will discuss these problems later in the video, but for now let's consider Jean Dubuffet's understanding. So Jean Dubuffet was born in 1901 in France, and in the year 1942 he joined with a group of artists to establish a non-commercial art association in Paris. In this year, he published a notice inviting individuals to share their unique and inspiring imagery. This notice requested art that drew upon the basic human experience and most spontaneous personal invention. It described, "We seek works in which the faculties of invention and creation that we believe to exist in every human being, at least at times, are manifested in a very immediate manner, without masks and without constraints." So the response to this notice was overwhelming and resulted in Dubuffet collecting many artworks from various individuals. He referred to this collection as the Collection de l'Art Brut, which consists of approximately 5,000 works by 133 creators. So this collection is currently housed in the Museum de l'Art Brut in Switzerland. Dubuffet's approach to aesthetics was relatively idealistic. He embraced a so-called low art, which challenged the traditional beauty standards. In his view, the unique works that he collected were examples of a more authentic and humanistic method to image making. According to Dubuffet, L'Art Brut represented a raw and uncooked depiction of the creative process, untouched by culture and formal artistic training. His writings were characteristically anti-bourgeois and encouraged audiences to turn away from art institutions. He declared, "Art made by professional specialists, I find it uninteresting. Instead, it is the production of art emanating from persons foreign to the specialized circle and elaborated by those shielded from any influence in a completely spontaneous and immediate way that interests me." So he further defines the category as works executed by people free from artistic culture, in which therefore mimicry, unlike what happens among intellectuals, has little or no part, so that their authors derive from it everything from their own background and not cliques of classical art or fashionable art. "We are witnessing the pure, raw artistic operation reinvented in the entirety of all its phases by the author, starting only from his impulses." Dubuffet's search for art that exists outside cultural concerns was headed for failure from the start, as no one can create from a situation that excludes any awareness of the world around them. However, Dubuffet established the idea of a non-cultural art, which exists in opposition to cultural art. The Swedish curator Michael Fethos discussed this polarity in his text Art Brut. He described how cultural art and insider art represents a slow and cautious shift away from the classical system of rules. However, these artists merely shift their focus to other representational systems, either from history or foreign countries. So therefore, the goal of cultural art is to achieve continuity between genres and art movement. So Fethos explained, "In the 19th century, the Romantic generation turned towards the East. The realists went to the popular imagery of the Dutch and the Spanish painting for inspiration, and the impressionists to Japanese prints. These borrowings were assimilated slowly in homeopathic doses, as if these foreign bodies were only admitted on the condition of merging into cultural organism without impairing its unity." So in contrast, Art Brut and outsider art is not concerned with aiding or breaking rules of aesthetic creations. They are instead indifferent to the questions of continuity and connection. So further described, there is no organic connection between them, nor interaction of any kind. He continues, their trajectories diverge or crisscross but never meet, each going its own way with sovereign indifference. Art brut does not serve to define anything, it is the name given to what cannot be bound by a definition. So art brut exists to challenge the ideology of representation, which is bound up by societal norms and expectations. This polarity exists to form an understanding between two creative processes, which are not entirely exclusive. For example, the subcategory Nouveau Invention is understood as a borderline category which straddles the boundary between insider and outsider art. So however, since the 1980s, the term has been transformed by art dealers and critics who now use it to reference any blend of art that exists beyond the borders of mainstream art. So this could include untrained artists, naive art, art from the third world and developing nations, folk art and children's art. So many people believe that any crude drawn can be considered in this category. So the art historian Colin Rhodes describes, in recent years, the term outsider art has begun to be used extensively to describe a bewildering range of artistic activity situated outside or in opposition to mainstream concerns. While it is surely desirable to maintain flexibility, there is a danger of the term becoming all-inclusive and therefore meaningless. Likewise, the scholar of folklore studies Daniel Wojcik describes how the term has become problematic, with many promoters and scholars acknowledging inconsistencies within the genre. He states, those who condemn the idea of the outsider art genre argue that the term is dehumanizing, ultimately reinforcing notions of artists as other, and marking individuals as pathological or primitive in relation to normal people and culture. Wojcik strongly suggests that outsider art is a classification that has been defined and imposed upon individuals by collectors, art critics, and dealers. He insists that artists labeled as outsider usually have little interest in defining their work in such terms. Nonetheless, most critics and writers agree that this style emerges from an artist's unique personal vision without any regard for cultural acceptance or praise. In this context, the artist is often regarded as disconnected from mainstream culture and working outside the fine art systems. There are often significant stylistic differences in this category. However, the artists are united by Dubuffet's belief in the raw and premeditated nature of their art arising as an imperative out of their inner selves. So Michael Feathers describes how these artists produce from the depths of their personalities, producing works of outstanding originality in concept, subject, and techniques. They are works which owe nothing to tradition or fashion. So I would love to hear some thoughts about this category. Have you heard of it before? And do you know anyone who creates works in this manner? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for listening.